Ciao, this is Davide Biocchi from Italy, and this is our midweek appointment with the intermarket analysis on currencies, commodities, and stock indices. First of all, let's focus on the euro dollar because finally, after wave one here, wave two, wave three, and probably wave four, waiting for wave five, we have seen the euro dollar at 120. It was the first day. And this is the first target that was, let me say, reached by the euro dollar currency exchange. So here we are with the figure that we had in the chart yesterday, showing that the market was able to reach 1.20, but then moved down. And this particular pattern with this candle, let me, well, is making me thinking that we can see again maybe 1.18, that is the main support that we have here. Well, we have another one a little bit over 1.17, exactly 1.1730, but I think that 1.18 could be good. And today we are continuing in this movement. Well, to be honest, the dollar index is very weak in this period, so the dollar is not weak only with the euro, but also with other currencies like the GBP pound, okay, that we can see here, and even here the target of 1.45 was more or less reached. We were missing only very few pips, but we can say that was reached. So again here we have a recovery of a dollar starting from yesterday, and maybe we will see 1.32, that is now the most interesting support that we can have here. But the pound is really very, very strong, and again the dollar is also weak with the Australian dollar. Let me check here. With the Australian dollar again, we can see here, even here in the last 2 days, there is a little change in the trend, but the trend is very clear. So very strong the Australian dollar. Very similar situation is connected with the New Zealand dollar. So show you the New Zealand dollar chart. Here we are. Okay. So again, here we have the same situation. And the same thing we have also if we compare the US dollar with the Canadian dollar. So here we are with this very strong trend. Probably this one is the most interesting and stronger trend that we can see in this currencies market. So the very good trend that the Canadian dollar have against the US dollar. It was able to come from 1.46 to 1.30. That is very, very interesting for this very, very interesting movement. Finally, we will see the US dollar compared with the Japanese yen. This is the more stable currency pair exchange. So what we can see here is that we are in a box in between 1.05 and 1.07. So the market is moving up and down this level, and this is, let me say, the most the less interesting one in terms of chart. To remain in terms of what is connected to the euro dollar, we have seen also some good interesting movement in some commodities. Imagine that due to the very strong moment of the dollar, the gold increased a lot. And also in the last session, when we met yesterday, 1.20, we have again the gold very close to $2,000 per ounce. But later the market came down, and even today it was really weak in the first part of the market session. Quite similar situation we have seen on the silver. A very similar situation we have seen on the silver. Okay, here we are with the silver. Even if the silver is stronger than the gold. So the maximum was reached at a little bit less than $30. Now the market is 28.24, and we can expect it to try again to reach this price, even if the first support area we can consider around 27.6 dollars. Again, we have a very interesting situation on the copper. The copper was able to overtake $3, and in this case, we have seen it coming back in an old, let me say, era prices, where the target we can say is a little bit over 3.25, exactly can be 3.31, can be considered, but this is not a target, in my opinion, that will be reached very soon. So it's something like some consolidation is necessary here, and then we will see a very interesting situation. $3 is now a support, even if we have another one at 2.75, that will work really interestingly. Also, 2.88 is another support level, very interesting here. For what concerning the commodities, let's finish also with the crude oil. The crude oil is now very stable. The price is continuing moving up a little bit, but really little bit and little bit. But now we are always around $43 per barrel. So the main support we can see in the chart is now $40. Second one is $35 that we can see here. Okay. Now the resistance will be probably 43.50, and then later we will have $50 as the let me say last one, probably 49 and 30, but more or less it's very close to 50. So these are the two more closer support and resistance. Let's switch now to the stock indices, in which we can see we can highlight the incredible performance of the Nasdaq. New historical high, very close to 12,500 points, really incredible. Imagine that this was, let me say, this was the crash connected to the COVID, and this was the recovery after. So we can see that the recovery was more than double the crash. The situation is really incredible. Imagine that the minimum here was around 6,600 and something. Now the market is more or less close to 6,000 points up. So imagine it is an increasing, very close to 90% from the minimum of March. Really incredible. Not similar, but not so far, is the situation of the S&P 500. The minimum was, let me say, here we are at more or less 2,200 points. Now we are at 3,550. We just overtake this price. This is incredible. 3,550, really incredible price. So the situation of the situation of the US market is really strong. On the other side, we don't have a quite nice situation on the European side, because if we look at the DAX, we see that the DAX is still yet around that price. So it's unable to overtake this resistance connected to 13,300. And we can say easily why. This is connected to the euro-dollar rate exchange, and this is because the lot of industries in Europe, they are producing in Europe, they are selling in dollars, they want to export to US, but this is very difficult because of the rate exchange that increased 10% since May. So this is crazy in a certain way for the European economy, and this is reflected also in the stock indices. So we have a DAX in a quite important difficulties, and all the other indices that are weaker than the DAX are really even in more difficulties. That's why the average that we can say is the Euro Stock 50 is still so far from the pre-COVID era. We are still missing 200 points and more, 250 points exactly, to come back to the pre-COVID era here. So this is very interesting. Imagine also that if we look at the Italian index, we can see that we are going up and down in 1,000 points, very thin volatility since 1 month, okay? In this case, we can say that the main support is around at 19,000, the main resistance is 20,500, and we are in between this level, up and down with the thin volatility. But we are in a certain way not so far from the figure that we can see, like a box that we can see on the Euro Stock 50. So Europe is in such in a such more difficulty than US, and US are doing very good. Especially if we consider some stock, imagine what happened to Zoom really up and boosted on the let me say because of the numbers they released. So this is really incredible. But imagine also that they let me say, if we consider price on sale, they are around something that is 150, so something really crazy. So we are probably in a bubble, I don't know, but until the moment the bubble is continuing, we must ride the bubble. So this is what we can do. Thank you for listening. This is Davide Biocchi from Italy. Ciao, ciao. See you soon.